More than 143 million Americans, almost half the population of the United States, live in areas that are vulnerable to earthquakes. The West Coast is particularly vulnerable and has experienced 30 earthquakes of magnitude 5.0 or greater over the last 10 years. But earthquakes can happen almost anywhere in the U.S. In the central U.S., the New Madrid seismic zone is a significant threat that can affect 8 states. Even parts of the East Coast are vulnerable. Alaska and Hawaii are also prone to major earthquakes. In any location, earthquakes have the potential for loss of life and economic and social disruptions. For a community, critical lifelines are drinking water and wastewater utilities. With thousands of utilities across the country, there will be many located in medium or high hazard areas for earthquakes. Utilities should be aware of this earthquake hazard and the potentially devastating impacts to public health and the environment. For a drinking water system, an earthquake can cause hundreds, even thousands of breaks in water pipelines, as well as ruptures in storage tanks and collapses of treatment buildings. For example, in 2014, a magnitude 6.0 earthquake near the city of Napa, California, caused 120 water main breaks during the first week and damaged a water storage tank. Some customers completely lost drinking water service or were on precautionary boil water advisories. And wastewater systems in the U.S. are certainly not immune to damage from earthquakes. The impacts could create sewage backups in homes and releases of untreated wastewater into the environment. Additionally, earthquakes can cause massive power outages, which can interrupt or completely halt pumping and treatment operations. So, what can water and wastewater utilities do to mitigate potential damage and service disruptions? Start by using EPA's Earthquake Resilience Guide for water and wastewater utilities. This easy-to-use, clickable guide is based on the experience of many utilities that have successfully mitigated impacts from earthquakes. The guide takes you step by step. The first step is to understand the earthquake threat to your utility. This step will take you to the EPA's Earthquake Interactive Maps. These maps show areas in the country that are more likely to experience damaging earthquakes. You can type in or zoom into your location and find out about the level of hazard at your utility. For example, zooming into Memphis, Tennessee, you see a pink area, meaning there is a very high chance that Memphis and its utilities could suffer from damaging earthquakes. The next step is to identify vulnerable assets and determine consequences. Start by making a list of assets that are critical to your operations. These may include electrical panels, certain pumps, pipes, and even buildings. Then determine if an asset may be damaged or fail from the shaking or ground motion. For example, the guide tells you which types of pipes and building structures may be vulnerable to earthquakes. Then you can determine how potential failures may impact your facility operations. Will you lose some capacity or disrupt your entire system? Then, it's time to choose mitigation measures to protect your critical assets. Here, EPA's guide can help identify mitigation strategies. For example, one strategy is to use codes and standards when building new structures or retrofitting existing facilities for seismic hazards. Another strategy described more in the guide is to protect the backbone of the system, including key treatment facilities, transmission lines, and storage tanks, because you can't protect every pipeline. A lower cost mitigation option is to anchor and brace pipes, tanks, pumps, and laboratory shelving. Your customers and your community are relying on you to provide safe water for drinking and to treat wastewater to protect their health and the environment. So start to make your utility earthquake resilient by using EPA's Earthquake Resilience Guide and EPA's Interactive Earthquake Maps at www.epa.gov/waterutilityresponse and click on the bullet Build Earthquake Resilience.